Welcome back to Project Watch. This is Serpy. Now today I'm going to talk about a couple of cases where it seemed like, say, a portion of them dropping the news back to back, right? And it surrounds a number of individuals who have been charged for some serious offenses, but it seemed like they might get baby sentence. Now, of course, you would have probably heard by now that the driver, right, for the team that carried out the now infamous church shooting that involved a lady by the name of Andrea Lowe Garwood. This happened in Falmouth, Shilani. The driver gets 6 years. Then we're also hearing that 87 by the name of Omar Johnson get 15 years to murder. I'm going to spend more time on this case. This is what the main video is about. But also, you might have heard that one of your favorite artists then get 3 years. What's going on? I'll tell you what's going on. My name, I plead guilty. There used to be a time when all of the 87 years to witness today, them now plead guilty. That changing now. Even the justice ministry encouraged people for us plead guilty. It free up the courts, take less paperwork off of them, and but it make man do some time where you really have to laugh. Plus, not only are some of them pleading guilty, but they're also cooperating with the justice system to sink somebody else. That is what happened in the case, the Andrea Lowe Garwood case. The driver, he's going to work with the justice system to help sink the rest of the man then. So the 6 years that he can get is a combination of the guilty plea plus the courts now go bother push the rest of the case then when they try to put upon him, because remember, they did also want to get him for conspiracy to murder and anything then, right, an accessory, right, before the fact. So them things that get dropped, right, in my work with the police then, my work with the justice system, testify, say what him know, sink the rest of man them, right, get him 6 years, probably come out in a like chair, 2 or 3 and going back in the yard. You see this thing I turn into a loophole. Now me understand the Andrea Lowe Garwood case to the driver. Because even though he did play a role in night, it's not like say they met the shooter get 6 years. Right, or the youth planet 6 years. But you see if man of Godos plead guilty and get some small sentence, then again, where is the deterrent? It's a fine line and a fine balance between, alright, who want to get through people, prefer the justice system, but also drop some sentence where at least look like it deliver justice. The main case I'm going to talk about is the case surrounding 87 family name Omar Troy Johnson. See, in February 2020, don't know how many people remember this, but there was a grandmother by the name of Sybil Malcolm, right? Or Sidel Malcolm, right? But people call her Sybil. She was at her house, right, in Cornwall Court, Montego Bay. Man decides to go broke into the house, you know, home invasion. Granny jump up, woke up into the man name. She and the 87 went at it. Yes, Granny went toe to toe with the 87 in her house, because let me tell you something, in my opinion, one of the worst crimes somebody can ever experience is a home invasion, because your home is your fortress, your home is your castle. And they say you're supposed to feel the safest and you're supposed to kind of put on your head. And when somebody violate that, you find strength where you not even know so you have. See, one thing, if you walk on the road and somebody say, give me this, and you might say, alright, take it and go on. But when somebody come into your house and violate your house, right, you find courage where you never even know so you have. Right. Because I've seen people say, why she never this and why she never do that? You come to the middle of the night and catch somebody in your house, certain instincts take over, especially if Grand Pitney and family there. Now, notice a granny got toe to toe with him and them. See, Jamaican homes need more men. Tired of telling this modern day concept where people keep forcing down the ears, but this if granny could have done so much damage, can I go hear much damage she do? If granny could have done so much damage by herself, if she'd have a man in the house, not a big man, and who knows how it could have ended. Nice, in a yard at night time, is a man supposed to go check out that. We see granny have to go do it to herself. In the course of her life. Anyway, granny put up a hell of a fight because she inflicts so much damage on the 87 last before him end up shooting her. The way he mash up, he might end up in the hospital. Right. When he go to hospital, I saw the mole on him. Him and granny at it. Right. And if he never have the gun in him hand, your favorite 87 will lose the fight. Your favorite bad man. Your favorite idol. If him never have the gun, or shoot granny, you know. Him and granny go toe to toe. And him end up shoot granny in her head after him pick up some severe injuries. Gaspar go check in the mole on him. Well, he's now plead guilty and he has been sentenced to 15 years. Not 50, not 50, but 15, 15. 15 years. Killing granny in front of her grand picking them. Now, I'm going to put a little excerpt on the screen. Because the police are basically saying, you know, well done. You know, a great job and all these things. But wanting to read the words in for yourself. Check this out. Well, if you want to read more about what happened to Miss Cyril Malcolm, right, they're all over the place. They're on Western Mirror. That can be they're on Jamaica Star and all them places there. Right, so look on your screen. This is what one of the top cop then, for the St. James, say regarding the same case. As you can see in our bowl, him say we are coming at them. This is a good day for the law-abiding citizens of St. James and the police, said the parish police commander, Superintendent Vernon Ellis. Right. Make sure I highlight and partner with him, say. We want the other violence producers in St. James to realize that we are coming at them with all the tools in our toolbox. And when they are caught, and we know they will be caught, that they stand to spend many years behind bars. Those are confident words. Okay, no problem. Nothing wrong with him having faith in his operation and what them can do. Fine, can't knock him for that. But Mendeline, many years, I can't do 15 years in my talk. You know, maybe him said this before the sentence, so he really know how, him just knows, alright, man, I got a deal, but nobody tell him to say 15 years, because I can't do 15 years for killing no man, I mean by many years. Right. Anyway, look on this next excerpt. The soup goes on to state, right, that the scientific evidence and the shrewdness of the detectives left him no other choice but to become a proactive cooperator. I hope the other 87s will realize that while they may be able to intimidate witnesses, they cannot intimidate DNA. I mean, the soup sure knows how to give a convincing statement, that's for sure. Right. You know, that may be able to intimidate witnesses, but it cannot intimidate DNA. Now, on the notice, he mentioned proactive cooperator. That sounds like a fancy way of saying that the pipe a leak. Right. Proactive cooperator. Because he just appeal guilty for himself. And then, you know, again, I tried to research exactly what that means. And I found an article in America where in that example, somebody was wearing a wire. Right. But, you know what it means in that context, proactive cooperator. Very interesting. Choice of words there. But this is what I want. Seeing as though, as I say, you can go read it, pan star for yourself, if you see all things when them collect, because them get too much shirt and much DNA, because as I say, him and granny was having a little matchup. And he ended up left things from the scene. But since them get more scientific evidence, right, and DNA and all them things, again, put an asterisk out there, a disclaimer, I am no legal expert. But since, if we don't have DNA, man, why then him even get chance to plead guilty? I don't understand. Is it a case where there's nowhere in the law that can prevent you from pleading guilty? Because me, I think to myself, all right, well, the system take the guilty plea because they must say, all right, well, if we go look for evidence, I don't really have much, but I may have this and but since I'm going to plead guilty, I could have done the case and so. But if me have DNA and everything, I can sink you for 40 years. If you then can just plead guilty, then you will beat the system every single time. So, who really wins? Is it optional, right, to plead guilty? Because if it is, the 87 win every single time. Because we can say, alright, police need to do more DNA. Police need to do more technology. And police need to solve more cases so that we can put more 87s away. Put them away for 15 years. Because if you go through, if me 87, you go tell me, say, you come knock on my cell and say, alright, we just find bare evidence for you. Know? We have 3 witness plus DNA, you're done for. The 40 years. 35 to life. And me say, where you say you find DNA? Alright, call me a liar there. Plead guilty. How exactly have you won anything? And me just win. Based on what I see, I said 87 of them a win. If me can just plead guilty and get a little sentence after you come to your big DNA and do your scientific evidence, right, then you know been none. If me say, we plead guilty and the court system say, no, we don't want a guilty plea for you, you're going to do your full sentence, then sure, but this new plea bargain and take this and take that and let's face it, 87s are winning. If you can't catch me with gun. If you can't catch me, if my name can't stink in the streets as an 87, you can't catch me with a weapon. And when they catch me and them say, yes, sir, you know, long one, well, you have a beer problem in a Spanish town and you have a beer problem in a jungle. And they say, hey, what you say? You finally get rid of me? Plead guilty. 3 years, 4 years, touch back the road. 9 months in some cases. Who's really winning? I mean, I know, I'm just saying. Because you see, when people say, oh, bring back, we need to bring back the rope and start put the rope on because the tired fee, if 87 years say the maggot dead, the maggot, no. You know why that won't work? Because the maggot does plead guilty. Remember in the Charmaine Ratchet case, the DPP tried to send some of them to the rope, you know. That wouldn't beat the system. Again, once them hear about the rope, once them hear about the 40-year sentence and they say you have evidence, you have witness, right? The man just plead guilty. It's a loophole. It's a loophole. How much money do you think I'm going to risk it? If you know, say, all right, system of DNA and evidence on him, and I'm going to risk getting the rope or risk 40 years, man, I'm going to plead guilty. It's the new loophole. Right? So one time, no man now plead guilty because man used to think, say, yeah, me can just turn up with a big shot lawyer. That was when time you could have intimidated witness easy. Nowadays, witness are turned up to court. And because witness are turned up to court, right, they are going to have them suffer. So man said, alright, even if your witness won't come, even if you have a solid case, guilty. See you in 10 years, your honor. Back on the streets. Obviously, I understand the justice system backlogged on them one, get through cases and some push people for. Yeah, man, listen, all that, but guess what? That's your problem, and you need to sort that out. The victims of these people, no one working at them family house, put multiple rounds in them granny head, and go give them a 15-year sentence. It might be good for the justice system because them get to pass through people and say, yes, Steve, we'll get rid of backlog. Yeah, but the people them who actually lose them loved ones, There's no way they can be satisfied with a 15-year sentence. None. 15 years? I don't know, still, as me say, I'm no legal expert. I'm sure maybe one of them big shots can come break it down better, right? In one of them press conference. Or maybe an MP or, you know, some legal expert, right? In the house need to talk about this. Right. I met people them know is the case where the option is there, or the justice system can say, you know what, based on who you are and based on what you do and based on the amount of evidence you have, in a wanna be guilty plea. If that's the case, then alright, well, listen, but if it's a case where the option is always there for us to plead guilty, then let me say, man, I gotta just take the option and beat the system every single time. So all you people will have said, bring back the rope and bring back, it's in Agaham, sorry. Because if there's even the most remote a chance, say 87, realize that you want to get the thing, you might just plead guilty, take a lesser sentence, and go back in yard in 15 years. But look on the bright side, at least, the backlog in the court system get reduced, I guess, I don't know. And why would the Justice Ministry even encourage people to plead guilty? Who remember that? When they were like, just plead guilty, what does that have to do with you? I encourage man to plead guilty, like. I guess for them, at the end of the day, it's just numbers. Right, but of course, the only people who get the slap in the face, you know, are the relatives and the loved ones of the victims who then see say that money are broken in them relatives' house, give them granny how much run at it and then get 15 years, get one 8 years, get one 6, and them alone really get the slap in the face. From the justice system point of view, they're winning because they might get through the cases and they might get through this and might get through that. So, I don't know what I'm going to say. I mean, I know the legal side of it. And before the woke activists and the false equivalent specialists jump out and start trying to sound deep and say, see, how comes he got life and he only got 15? That shows you that there is a... If you plead guilty, the law secretaries are sentenced. And if you plead not guilty and carry a trial and then go lose, then fling away. And even that flingway is not real flingway. Because in Jamaica, life doesn't mean life. The number you want to look at is the amount of years before parole. This you get 15 and you will live 14 years before you live parole. Anyway, Patreon squad, big up on yourself. PIA, you don't know, more life. Vulture squad, stay circling. Yes.